Today, we're going to walk through the basics of simultaneous camera and object tracking in SynthEyes. I want to perform a semi-automated object track. What I mean by that is that I won't create any supervised trackers, I'll only use auto features. Let's jump straight into the Roto Masking tab and use MaskML to distinguish different elements. When opening the MaskML dialog, it automatically creates a layer. I'll use this first layer to make an exclusion mat for the man in the center, so I'll name it accordingly, and then click in the viewer to make a selection. For this shot, I'm going to create multiple layers, then propagate them all at once. So let's create another one by clicking the Create button. I'll use the second layer to avoid tracking the motion of the ocean waves, since I definitely don't want SynthEyes placing auto trackers on the water. We might even want having multiple reference frames for the ocean layer to make sure the selection stays consistent, so I'll scrub through the timeline and create another selection later in time. Finally, I click Create one more time. This third layer won't be for exclusion. Instead, we will use it to tell SynthEyes which specific object we want to track. In this case, the surfboard. I make a selection and name the layer Surf. Now let's propagate the mats for all layers by clicking this button. This shouldn't take more than a minute. Great! The last step is to tell SynthEyes that one of these layers should actually be used for an object track. I go to Shot, Add Moving Object, and the green diamond appears in the viewer, indicating that now we have an object in our scene. Now in the left panel, I change the surf layer from being a garbage mat to an object. The rest of the layers stays as they are. Now we are ready to move forward and generate some auto trackers. I'll jump over to the Features room. However, I want to tweak some default settings for tracker generation, so I'll go to the Advanced. My shot is 250 frames long, so I'll slightly bump up the tracker count to 200. Since I'm working with a 4K plate and the areas where I want my trackers are slightly out of focus, I'll also increase the small and big blip sizes to 12 and 24 respectively. Now to generate the trackers, let's go ahead and click through Blip All Frames, Bill All, Clear All Blips. Now we've got a bunch of 2D trackers spread across the shot. Since we've separated the areas with MaskML, here I can change what set of trackers is now highlighted. For the camera, we have a solid number of trackers on the ground and the backclef. As for the object, the surfboard had some sand and dirt on it, meaning there were enough fine details to generate a good amount of object trackers. Even though some of these trackers might be a bit slippery and not pixel perfect, the fact that we have so many means they reinforce each other and the errors get averaged out. So this should work fine for our solve. Now I will turn down the alpha mask capacity, jump over to the solver room and see if I can get a clean solve. I click the big green go button and in just a moment we get our first solve. The HPX error for both the camera and the object looks decent enough. Looking at the top 3D view, we can see the moving camera's path along with a cloud of trackers moving throughout the space. However, notice that the object's path doesn't look quite right in 3D. It appears as if the surfboard is moving towards the camera, where in reality it's not. It's also placed much further away than the set of ground features, where it roughly should be. The reason for this is that SynthEyes doesn't know how far the object is from the camera. Luckily, there is an easy fix. I don't have distinct measurements of the scene, but I can estimate a close enough position by eye based on the features on the ground. Here's how I do that. First, I'd find a 3D feature on the ground that appears to be closest to where the serve board should start. This spot right under the man's feet is a perfect candidate. I'll mark it with a different color here, changing it from green to something else. The reason I do this is that I can now use it as a visual reference. Since I know that the serve board should be just slightly behind the spot, it gives me a solid idea of where the object should be placed in its starting position. Now it should be easy to move the object. Make sure you have the object tracker selected here. Now on the left panel, enable the Hold button and choose Scale. By adjusting this parameter, you can move the object closer or further away from the camera. Now I can switch back to the camera trackers to make our reference tracker visible. Notice how the entire object's path is affected and changes its shape as I move it closer to the camera. It shifted from moving towards the camera to moving more to the left, which now looks like the proper motion. Now, let's bring in the actual geometry and see if everything fits. First, make sure you have the object tracker selected here. Then go to File, Import, Mesh. The next step is to align it with the trackers and place it correctly in 3D space. Use these buttons on the left to choose whether to move, rotate, or scale the mesh. Click and drag in any of the 3D views to perform the chosen action. Once you have a rough position, it's better to use pins for precise alignment. Switch to the perspective view and enable pinning toolbar. You can hide the trackers by hitting J on the keyboard. Choose Create Edit Pins, then click on a mesh to create one. With one pin, you can adjust only the X and Y positions. With two pins, you can adjust rotation and scale. And with three or more, you can move the mesh in all dimensions. To delete a pin, hold Ctrl and left-click on it. You can delete all pins at once by clicking the related button in the toolbar. At this stage, I'd use the pins to align the mesh. Unfortunately, the model I have doesn't perfectly match the photography, but it's close enough to get the job done and demonstrate the workflow. So I've aligned the mesh the way I'm happy with it, but if I scroll through the shot, you'll notice it slides a bit. That's because we positioned the model based on the perspective view in just one frame, but the mesh isn't quite in the right spot in the 3D. To fix this, we can project the trackers onto the mesh and use it as a constraint. First, select a few object trackers while holding Shift. Then go to Track and drop onto Mesh. SynthEyes will create a set of constraints based on the mesh shape. Now, to make sure SynthEyes uses those constraints, turn on the corresponding checkbox in the solver room. Change the solving algorithm from automatic to refine for both camera and the object. Now let's refine the scene and click Go. Okay, notice that after setting the constraints and refining the scene, the object error went up a bit. That's because we essentially limited some of the SynthEyes' freedom. But that's fine, because if I play through the shot, the mesh stays aligned with the imagery much better throughout the shot and it no longer drifts. The final step, of course, is exporting the scene. I find FBX to be the most convenient option for bringing a scene into Houdini. Once I import the scene, I get a moving camera, a set of nulls representing the trackers, and the geometry attached to one of those nulls. Everything I need to continue building the project is right at hand. And that wraps it up. There is a lot more to explore when it comes to geometry tracking, but by now you should be familiar with the core concepts and basic steps. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one!